Alright guys, welcome back. Daku here with our Let's Play of Legend of Dragoon. Obviously, Darth is there waiting for us to get back into motion of things. Last we left off, we just found out that something happened to Shauna. Shauna is our childhood friend from this village. And as far as we know, everybody's pretty much dead. So we gotta find out a ways to find out what happened to Shauna, where they took Shauna. If you haven't figured it out, spoilers, Shauna's the girl that was in the cutscene in the first episode. Oh good, somebody is alive. Yes, my name is Dart. Short for D'Artagnan. Just kidding, I don't know if it's short for anything, it's probably just Dart. He says, if only I came back earlier. If I came back earlier, I'd still be just a level 1. Yes, it's true, I took down 2 soldiers, but I don't think I could take off a whole freaking army. Here we go, what's wrong with Shauna? Shauna's... This guy's got answers. Yeah, that's where she is, Helena Prison. Let's go ahead and kill this guy. Yes. Double flash. Take care of the little guys because they do that. Wow, 6 damage. Can't take too many of those. Go ahead and use an item here. This is called Burnout. It's a magic item. As you can see here, it says flame, so it's fire-based. Sorry. And multi. Multi means you have to hit the X button repeatedly in order to get a better damage output. So pretty much I just button mash this thing. You can probably hear me button mashing right now. The highest I've ever seen is go up to 200%. So 11 damage, that was pretty good. No! Sorry guys, gotta cough again. healed himself for 4. So that means that he's probably almost dead as is. This probably brings him down to the red zone. And I'm almost dead too, freaking out. There we go. Pretty simple fight. Of course it has to be, it's only like a small mini boss. Got 2 healing potions and a burnout for that 24 experience, which means we go up a level. I think we also get a new addition as well. Yep, there we go. Come on, exit. There we go. Now, for those of you who haven't played this game before, this game, I think we talked a little bit about it in the first episode, but this game came out in the 2000 era, 2000-2001 to North America. This game is kind of a long game. It spreads out across 4 discs. Yeah, that's quite a bit. But anyway, this game, I spent a lot of time in this game. This game took me several years simply just because it was kind of hard. Not all the fights are going to be straightforward like the ones that we've experienced so far. A lot of them do require some strategy as to how you should maneuver. Not really maneuver, but how you should plan out your attacks and defenses and such. Back when I first started, I just ran headlong into this game, and I just was horrible at it. I didn't take any planning. It probably wasn't until I started planning until I was able to beat the game. I think I accumulated over 60 hours of gameplay on it. We're gonna talk to these kids. As soon as I know how to learn how to use a door that isn't there. Want to check around these areas simply because every once in a while you'll find things hidden, like barrels or even buckets like that one. What I'm looking for is something called stardust, which will help us in later game, but you would actually have to find these things all across the game. So this guy's alive, you're not wasting the medicinal herbs on him. Alright, there we go. You doing okay, dude? I shamelessly came back. What do you mean your feelings towards Shauna? Shut up. Usually if there's a stardust, there's a small, like, little glint or glimmer. I could swear that there's, like, one on a tombstone here. I guess not. Purple lady. This guy is Tasman, that's his name. Master Tasman, he's the guy who taught us how to use a sword. See, told you. Yeah, why not? I might as well go over a few basic gameplay stuff. Sorry, guys. Go over a few basic gameplay stuff to show you guys. There's only like about another 5 minutes left in the episode, so I might as well just show you guys some of the gameplay that we didn't go over. Usually when your character's crouching like that, it means that they're down into the red zone of health. I'll be okay this time, simply because This is just like a practice battle, just how to go over stuff. You guys have already seen double slash, which is the two slashes from, well, name says it all, the two slashes with the sword. But I think in this one we actually use a more complex one, the volcano, that we just learned. Sight overlaps the square in the center. Push the X button. Gray means too fast, blue means too slow, white means perfect. Just so that way you guys can still practice.
Yes.
Oh, messed up. Volcano there has 4 hits, which is pretty good. More time. Very good. Counterattacking. So every once in a while, the enemy will counterattack. No, not all enemies counterattack, but few do. As it says here, during the attack, they might show hints of a counterattack. And that's the hint, red sparks. Get through that, instead of pushing X, you press circle. So when you fail, push X or you miss the circle mark, you get blown away, meaning you also take damage. And that turn ends. So we're gonna try it out with Volcano here. Anyway, so you get the gist of the thing. Of the counterattacks. No, don't show me again. About defense. So we'll go over some defense here. Like I was talking about before. As I was talking about before, if you guard for a turn, all incoming damage is reduced by half. And that means physical attacks, magic attacks. But you also regain 10% of your max health. And so that's a good viable way for you guys to cheaply recover your health. What the hell, you're going on a journey? Soon, as a matter of fact. Why are you leaving the people behind? You need to stay and watch these people, because as far as I know, the only ones that are taking care of people are the two kids. You need to stay, old man, get better, and take care of people. Alright, guys. Oh. Never mind. I was going to say we're going to cut it off here, but go through this little bit first. Just me, or did anybody else see the rat move parallel to the floor while climbing up that wall? Amazing. Oh boy. Alright guys, this is the overworld. I'm gonna save it here, and I'm also gonna end the episode here. Just over 15 minutes, but when we come back, guys, we'll pick up where we left off and head on our way to Helena Prison to save Shauna. Peace out, guys, and I'll see you all later.